Welcome to the Media Agent Design Fundamentals module presented by Commvault. In this module, you will learn the fundamentals of media agent design for a Commvault solution. You will learn how to use the information that you gathered through the solution discovery phase, including the environment overview and data profiles. This information will help you determine the locations where media agents should be placed, how many are required, and what specification they should be. We'll cover certain sizing and hardware specifications for media agents, along with a deeper view into their technology and anatomy. On completion of this module, you will be able to architect a solution with the optimal media agent design that is supported by Commvault. Now let's look at media agent components and how to properly place them. The media agent, an essential part of every solution's data plane, comprises of various physical and logical components that we'll cover next. The first physical component of a media agent is the compute layer. Although typically deployed on physical hardware, an increasing number of media agents are deployed as virtual instances, either on-prem or in the cloud. Media agents typically generate significant I/O, so careful planning of virtual resources is required. The second physical component of a media agent is the storage targets that are used to hold the various copies of production data. At least one media agent must have write capabilities to copy production data to storage. The storage can be direct attach, including block storage, network attached storage, or cloud storage. Storage targets can also be removable media like tape or cloud migration devices, for example, Amazon Snowball storage. The next component of a media agent is the logical storage plans. A plan defines where data gets copied, how long that data remains there, the SLA, and the various storage utilization features. This information is covered in the plans module. Another component of a media agent is the software agent or agents required to communicate with production systems. Depending on the requirements, additional software can be installed on the media agent, which enables native communication with the production systems, reduces overhead, and enables data translation, for example, reading from one hypervisor and then writing to another. The final component of a media agent are the functions that it can perform as directed by a workflow, plan, or administrator action. Three primary functions that are performed by a media agent are backup, restore, and data replication through several methods and mechanisms. Media agent placement is key to delivering a successful solution and is answered very easily by asking a single question. Where are we writing the data to? There's a bit more to it when we factor in scale, resiliency, and security, but in its simplest form, anywhere you need to write a local copy of data will require at least one media agent. In this example, our same customer that we've profiled back in an earlier module would require at least one media agent in their active production data center located in Chicago for local backup copies. There would be another in the DR site over in San Jose, where we have a DR ComServe standing by alongside an always-on media agent to receive the additional copy of data. Finally, the small remote site in Santa Clara also requires a local copy of data residing in this office for recovery purposes. So we place at least one media agent there too, to then pass it along to the active data center for redundancy purposes. This is just a typical configuration when customers want to keep their data on-premises, but what if your customer wants to pursue a more forward-thinking solution, like public cloud? Building your data plane in the cloud is possible with Commvault, with availability for even the ComServe to be built into the cloud as well. Bad design here can lead to significant egress costs that could outweigh the benefits of performing operations in the cloud. So let's take a look at an optimal design for a customer using Ashra. Let's say that in our prior example, both Chicago and San Jose are kept in separate regions in Ashra's cloud. Chicago's data to be backed up is all squared away in its respective region, while San Jose is also in its own respective region. Data may be commonly segregated this way in order to maximize their own operations. With Chicago being the main production center of our customers' operations, the ComServe will be located in the region along with a lightweight software package, Cloud Controller, but more on that in a bit. Access nodes are used to read the data in question, and as such, are deployed as virtual machines within Azure, which can be scaled automatically using Commvault technologies to meet the demand as it happens. With Commvault's intelligent data services, assessments of your defined recovery point objective and throughput averages are automatically calculated to determine how many more access nodes may need to be deployed through Commvault's auto-scaling features. Media agents are also located within the region to act as the data movers and hosts of the deduplication databases that will help on data savings. High-performing disks are provisioned here to manage deduplication-related operations. One last piece of the puzzle is a cloud accelerator that will help expedite the data transfer to storage by having each of the clients write directly to Azure storage, helping to reduce traversal costs normally associated with the cloud. In this configuration, egress charges are minimized whenever data protection operations occur, with the use of the deduplication databases held on the respective media agents. Only metadata signatures are sent to the media agent to perform a hash comparison, which determines when to write unique blocks of data to an available Azure blob through the cloud storage accelerator deployed on the clients being protected. As the needs of the environment scale and access nodes are deployed automatically to meet the necessary demand, the cloud controller will handle all of the necessary power management to avoid the costs that come when running persistent compute. The Cloud Storage Accelerator removes the need for data to land on the media agent to write to storage by allowing each of the individual clients to write directly to the Azure blob. San Jose will act as a catch-all for data to be copied over from Chicago. Using deduplicated auxiliary copies, otherwise known as dash copies, data transfer will thin out as the data is deduplicated over time, further minimizing bandwidth-related costs. By storing the data in longer-term storage, like Metallic Recovery Reserve, a fully air-gapped solution can be achieved with a design like this. Public cloud configurations yield multiple opportunities for businesses to leverage the benefits of cloud computing's on-demand resources and global accessibility for their data protection needs. Now that we've talked about placement options, let's move on to media agent sizing. There are two basic but important considerations when designing media agents. How many are needed and what size should they be? You should start by identifying all of the sites where a local copy of data needs to be written. You should have a good idea on this from solution discovery phase earlier. Next, factor in the amount of front-end terabytes and the profile of that data, which will be ingested in each site. You can use that information gained from the data profiling exercise for this step. These figures are not a sizing metric of the media agents themselves, but are used in the next step. Step 3, calculate the backend terabytes to be stored in order to meet the retention and replication retention requirements for each site. 4, match the backend terabytes to the appropriate media agent grid or grids in order to meet the solution requirements. Customers are likely to refine different criteria and requirements along the way. You should always avoid situations where this aspect of a solution is undersized, which will inevitably cause problems later on. For example, having one too many deduplication databases on a single media agent could cause performance bottlenecks across the board. Conversely, oversizing a solution at this stage could exclude you from a deal entirely. Your end goal here is to balance your design with a number of correctly sized media agents and storage to satisfy all requirements of the solution while providing room for scalable growth. Remember that design architectures tend to evolve over time and you will likely have to factor in customer demands, such as future growth, budget constraints, or allegiance to a particular hardware vendor. Commvault provides a detailed specification guide for media agents using deduplication mode, which can be found on the Commvault documentation website. The specifications themselves are categorized into various sizes that make it easy to select the correct media agents to support the requirements of your design. Details about non-deduplicated environments can also be found on our documentation site. Each option provides a specific number of identically sized nodes, from as few as 1 or as many as 4 in a grid. Each grid equates to a backend terabyte figure up to a specific threshold, i.e. the amount of actual data it can store on the backend disk library, with some different recommendations for cloud-based libraries. The provided grid sizing automatically factors in the use of deduplication partition mode where required for scale. The single backend metric makes sizing the media agent grid a simple process. Please keep in mind that the suggested workloads are not software limitations, but rather design guidelines for sizing under specific conditions. For media agents that are deployed as a cloud or virtual instance, remember to follow both virtual compute and memory recommendations and ensure that resources are guaranteed. Please read the Commvault documentation carefully, as there are other important guidance notes provided. Also, the sizing metrics are updated from time to time, for example, following product feature releases. Media agent sizing is able to be completed with the help of the Commvault Solution Design Tool. The discovery tool is created specifically to help any Commvault employee or partner to scope a solution properly. Workload information collected from your data profiling sessions with your customer can be entered here. The tool will then provide a breakdown of the kind of resources that are going to be required for the environment, along with projecting the future needs that the same environment may require down the road. Be sure to use this tool to easily build, see, and share designs in order to deliver a complete proposal to your customer. Understanding the makeup and functionality of certain media agent-related procedures will help guide you in design. This slide describes the best practices for physical disk and logical drive layouts when planning your media agent deployments on Windows. We have chosen Windows as it is the most common media agent deployment, but the Commvault Media Agent software is supported on many other varieties of operating systems. Please refer to the Commvault documentation website to check supported OS types and versions. The Windows operating system and Commvault installation binaries should be installed on the C drive and placed on a RAID disk set configured on FastDisk. Some additional disk space is required for temporary files copied during the installation or upgrade and for log file growth. The media agent binaries may be installed on a separate disk set if you wish, but that is not essential. Whenever installing or reconfiguring a media agent, verify that the volume hosting the index cache directory has sufficient disk space and performance as per documented requirements. Our general recommendation is to use SSD if possible, especially for larger environments. This cannot be located on network storage under any circumstances. For optimal performance, the deduplication database needs to be on fast, dedicated disk. This will have the most significant impact on the performance of a media agent, so be sure to check the disk is capable of the IOPS documented for the size of the building block you are designing. Finally, the disk library can be designed using either direct or SAN-attached block storage or network-attached storage. Commvault provides added flexibility here, as the customer does not need expensive SAN or NAS storage for the disk library. They can shop for lower-cost, high-capacity storage from any number of vendors. This can also be a real selling point, as customers do not feel tied into a particular hardware vendor. Remember, media agents are the primary data handler between servers and storage targets. In order to determine the level of availability required in the design, you should refer to the SLAs required for the backup system captured during your solution discovery phase. An important differentiator for Commvault is that the deduplication database is only required to perform backups. When a recovery is performed, the index is identified within the CommServe database, the index is accessed, the storage location identified, and the restore is performed. This underlying architecture also means that a media agent can be easily recovered in the event of a disaster. Additionally, both the index cache and deduplication databases themselves are automatically protected and recovered if unavailable. To provide a higher level of availability for media agents that use deduplication, you should always design with 2, 3, or 4 nodes in a grid using partition deduplication. Partition deduplication distributes the DDB across these multiple media agent nodes. This provides partition failover by automatically redirecting the deduplication process if one partition is temporarily unavailable. Media agents also utilize grid store technology to provide automatic path failover should a media agent or storage target become inaccessible. This leads us on to the availability of the storage targets and the resident data itself. Resiliency may be built into the underlying storage targets themselves. However, in the case of disk-based storage targets, it is worth noting the difference between direct-attached block storage and NAS. With direct-attached block storage, the mount paths are locally attached to the media agent. If a media agent goes offline, then so does the storage target. With NAS storage, if a media agent goes offline, the disk storage is still accessible through other media agents. The Commvault index spans intelligently across multiple plans. If, when a restore is initiated, the appropriate media is not available, then the software automatically identifies the media in which the data resides and performs the restore from that storage target. Finally, when you are having availability type discussions, keep in mind Commvault Hyperscale technology. Hyperscale was designed specifically to provide improved resiliency of the media agent and storage components with lower costs and simplified management compared to traditional compute and storage architectures. Next, a quick refresher on a couple of other Commvault deduplication features that are likely to influence your design. Let's start with dash copy. Dash copy is a technology that enables the transmission of data in its deduplicated, reduced form factor between media agents. This includes the capability to recover data and maintain different retention periods independently from the primary copy. This reduction in bandwidth consumption facilitates disaster recovery and eliminates the need for vendor-specific appliances or third-party replication technologies for disaster recovery purposes. When sizing a solution that utilizes dash copy, the primary copy of data and any additional copies should be sized independently. This also includes dash copy configurations using cross-site replication. A DDB is also required on the destination media agent for dedupe signature comparison. Again, please refer to documentation.commvault.com for the latest hardware specifications for deduplication mode. We will now discuss synthetic and dash full backups and some best practices on using them. Synthetic full backups consolidate the data from the latest full backup or synthetic full backup together with any subsequent incremental backups instead of reading and backing up data directly from the client computer. Since synthetic full backups do not backup data from the client computer, this operation imposes no load on the client computer. With the duplicated data, a synthetic full by default utilizes a faster variation of a synthetic full called dash full, where only the deduplication and index records are updated without the need to read each block and generate a signature. Since the associated disk I/O is reduced significantly, a dash full results in much faster completion compared to a regular synthetic full. A common misconception is that synthetic fulls are a new backup, but in fact, the actual data protection is done by the latest incremental. The synthetic full itself is used to consolidate these previous backups for space reclamation via the data aging process. It is important to note that synthetic fulls have little or no impact on restore performance on disk or cloud storage targets. Commvault's single pass recovery process creates a recovery point image which represents the context of the whole data set at the time. Often you will hear customers state that they require a full backup once a week, a typical hangover from their usage of legacy products and methodologies. With Commvault, they really get that outcome every day in the recovery point, and that is thanks to smart indexing. The single pass recovery is still applicable with tape media, However, job-based restores from tape media can still benefit from full or synthetic full backups as these jobs consolidate data on the tape media. This consolidation can reduce the load and seek time and improve read efficiency. You should refer to the documented recommendations on scheduling synthetic full backups. It is strongly recommended that they are not run excessively, especially with deduplicated data, as this can lead to unnecessary load on the deduplication database. In the span of this module, we've covered 1. The pieces that make up a media agent, along with a couple of placement examples that can mitigate common factors in designs. 2. Properly sizing media agents and the Commvault solution discovery tool that can be used to aid in designing an environment. 3. The anatomy of a common media agent, along with availability considerations on how recovery works when losing a key media agent item like a deduplication database and index cache. And lastly, a quick refresher on deduplication and how it works with dash copies, while also highlighting the key differences between synthetic full operations and dash full operations. Thank you for watching.